Good morning, students. Welcome to my class. Today we are going to start with another activity. But at the beginning, we are going to remember the topic of the last class. The last class we review about the present passive voice. Do you remember? That's right. So can you tell me the structure of it? That's right. We are going to use the subject, the verb to be, okay, the main verb in the past participle form, and the agent or the complement. That's right. Okay, and can you tell me an example? That's right. The cell phone is bought by my mother. Okay, I am using the sentence using the correct structure of the present passive voice. Okay, as I said before, today we are going to review another topic. Today we are going to review past passive voice. And what is the objective for today? To explain the use of the past passive in sentences through an explanation and examples. So, do you know when do you use past passive voice? Do you know what is the structure? Okay, so today we are going to review that in order to understand better, okay? So pay attention. As I said before, in the last class we have active and passive voice, okay? We are going to remember some points of that. In English, we have two voices. Active and passive voice, okay? When the action of the verb is done to the subject, okay, that is an active voice. For example, here we have an example. The leopard chases the antelope, okay? Here we have the subject, the verb, okay? So the subject is doing the verb, okay? That is the difference. The subject is doing the verb, okay? It means the action of the verb is done to the subject, okay? So the subject does the verb, okay? We are going to review the passive voice, okay? That is the other part, okay? Passive voice is used when the focus is on the action. It is not important who or what is making the action. Okay, here we have an example. Also, we have the subject, the verb, and the complement. Okay, but pay attention. Subject is not doing the verb. Okay, so notice the difference. In active voice, the subject is doing the verb. Okay, but in passive voice, the subject is not doing the verb. With the passive voice, the action of the verb is done to the subject. Okay, so it means that in passive voice we are going to focus on the action. That's right. The antelope was chased by the leopard. Okay, so notice what is the difference between the two voices. Okay, note la diferencia entre las dos voces. En la voz activa, el sujeto es quien realiza la acción. En la voz pasiva, el sujeto no es quien realiza la acción. Y nos vamos a enfocar aquí en acción. ¿Ok? We are going to review the structure. ¿Ok? In order to create sentence using past passive voice, we are going to use the subject, was and were. ¿Ok? And the verb in the past participle plus the agent. ¿Ok? Here we have an example. The cake was eaten by Carla. Okay? In order to create my sentence, okay, I am following the structure, okay? The cake was eaten by Carla. When do you use was or were? Okay, remember, we have to conjugate it according to the subject, okay? Here we have a chart in order to show you when do you have to use was or were, okay? You are going to use were for the subject you. You are going to use was for the subject he, she, it, and I. Okay? And were for we, you, and they. Okay? That is the conjugation of the verb to be according to the subject, okay? So you have to keep in mind that. Usted tiene que tener en cuenta que el verbo to be siempre lo vamos a conjugar. En este cuadrito podemos observar las conjugaciones, ¿no es cierto? De acuerdo al sujeto, voy a utilizar were or was, okay? And don't forget to use the verb in past participle form. No se olvide utilizar el verbo en the past participle form, okay? That is the third column of your verb list. La forma del pasado participio es la tercera columna de su lista de verbos, that's right? And we are going to check the negative form, okay? Here also you have the structure, subject, was, were, plus not. Okay, remember, not give the characteristic to the sentence that is negative, okay? And the verb in past participle, also the agent. Here you have an example. The cake was not eaten by Carla. Okay? Here, that is almost the same structure of the affirmative sentence, okay? Casi es la misma estructura que la oración afirmativa. Lo único que estamos utilizando de nuevo aquí es el not. That is the way in order to make negative sentence. Esta es la manera de hacer una oración negativa. ¿Qué me dice aquí? The cake, el pastel, no fue comido por Carla. Okay? Here you have the agent. Aquí tenemos el agente. En algunos casos no lo vamos a tener y el agente no va a ser necesario. Pero si usted lo tiene, por favor lo puede utilizar. Si no lo tiene, no importa. Okay? And we are going to review the structure of the questions, okay? As you notice in questions, we have to change the order. So we are going to use was and were, okay, here. Then we are going to use the subject. Then we are going to use the verb in past participle form and also the agent, okay? So, was the cake eaten by Carla? How do you answer it? Okay, remember, that is a yes-no question, okay? Because you don't have a double H word. Esta es una pregunta de sí y no. ¿Cómo la puedo identificar? Porque no tengo una double H word, una palabra double H, es decir, las palabras que requieren más información, como what, where, when, why, okay? Si no tengo una de esas palabras, esto quiere decir que es una pregunta de sí y no. Por lo tanto, mis respuestas van a ser cortas. ¿Cómo puedo responder? Yes, it was, affirmative. No, it was not, negative, okay? Pay attention here. So you are going to use yes or not, the subject, was or were, okay? Aquí vamos a utilizar de acuerdo a nuestra pregunta. In negative, not, okay? Here I am using it because the cake is related to the subject it, okay? Aquí estoy utilizando it, ¿por qué? Porque the cake se refiere a think, ok, se refiere a una cosa, y para las cosas nosotros utilizamos el sujeto it, ok, remember, here solo podemos utilizar los sujetos I, you, he, she, it, we and they, ok, por lo tanto los tenemos que transformar. Ok, here we have a list of verbs, ok, aquí tenemos una lista de verbos. You are going to use that list, ok? Usted va a utilizar esta parte de la lista de los verbos para formular las oraciones in passive voice, that's right? Esta es la columna que vamos a utilizar. Here you have some examples of irregular verbs. Ok, estos son verbos irregulares. Lo que siempre les había mencionado es, in order to know what is the past participle form of the verb, you have to study. Para saber estas formas, nosotros solo tenemos que estudiar. Tenemos que estudiar, saber el verbo en presente, el verbo en pasado y la forma del verbo participio pasado. Como usted puede ver aquí, we don't have any rule in order to show us what is the correct form of the past participle form. Como usted se puede dar cuenta aquí, no hay ninguna regla que nos diga cómo se hace la forma del pasado participio. Por lo tanto, you have to study and you have to memorize, okay? Here we have the list of the regular verbs, okay? Esta lista es un poquito más fácil, porque in order to create the past participle form of the verbs, you only have to add ed. Para crear la forma del pasado participio de los verbos regulares, solo vamos a añadir ed. ¿Ok? Por lo tanto, esta sí es un poquito más fácil. Por ejemplo, feel, felt. Help, helped. Invite, invite. ¿Ok? Learn, learned. Listen, listened. ¿Ok? As you note here, we only add ed in order to create the past participle form of the regular verbs. ¿Ok? And we are going to check some examples. Okay, here I am going to show you how do you change the active voice into passive voice. Aquí les voy a mostrar un ejemplo de cómo transformar una voz activa a una voz pasiva. Okay, you have to remember that in active voice the subject is doing the action. Okay, in the passive voice the subject is not doing the action. Okay. That is the difference between. Pay attention here. María sent a letter to her mother. Algo que les tengo que aclarar aquí, estamos viendo past passive voice, ¿ok? Por lo tanto, mi oración activa tiene que estar en pasado, utilizando pasado simple para crear la voz pasiva, ¿ok? So, María sent a letter to her mother. As you notice, that sentence is in past simple. Como usted se dio cuenta, esta oración está en pasado simple. Lo que voy a hacer es, voy a hacer algunos cambios, ¿no es cierto? The letter was sent by Maria. Ok, so pay attention. Here we have the subject. Aquí tengo el sujeto, the verb, ok, and the object, ok, y aquí tengo el objeto. So pay attention. We are going to use at first the object, ok? Para hacer la voz pasiva tengo que utilizar primero el objeto, the letter, el verbo to be en pasado, was. Aquí estoy utilizando was because the letter is singular. Porque esto es singular. Was sent, ok? Estoy utilizando el verbo en pasado participio, by Maria, que este es el agente, ¿no es cierto? El sujeto de la oración activa viene a ser el agente de la oración pasiva. María sent a letter. Ok, María is the person who makes the action. La persona que hizo la acción. The letter was sent by María. Ok, so notice here the subject doesn't do the action. Ok, aquí podemos observar que el sujeto no es el que hace la acción. Que dice aquí, María envía una carta. La carta fue enviada por María. So notice the difference. Ok. Okay, and we are going to check the last example, okay? That is the same. Here we have the active voice and the passive voice. Nosotros revisamos también, la anterior fue una oración afirmativa, ahora vamos a ver una oración negativa. Como les mencionaba, the active voice has to be in past simple, ¿no es cierto? Como les mencionaba, la voz activa tiene que estar en pasado simple. En este caso es una negativa, usted ya sabe cómo se hace una oración en el pasado simple en forma negativa. So, they didn't not steal a bank. Okay? That is a negative sentence in past simple form. Esto es una oración negativa en la forma pasado simple. And we are going to change in past passive voice. Y le voy a transformar en la voz pasiva. Okay? Pasado pasiva. Here you have the subject, the negative form, the verb, and the complement or the agent, ¿ok? El complemento o el agente. En este caso, o objeto, ¿no es cierto? En este caso, ¿qué voy a hacer? Voy a utilizar primero el objeto, a bank, was, ¿ok? En este caso es lo mismo, utilizo was porque mi sujeto es singular. A bank was not, ¿ok? Esto es la forma negativa porque mi oración activa estaba en negativa, por eso esta también va a ser negativa. Was not stolen, ok, that is the verb in the past participle form. Esto es el verbo stolen es la forma pasada participio del verbo steal. And also here I don't put the agent, aquí yo no puse el agente. Como les mencionaba, si usted tiene el agente lo puede poner, si no tiene el agente no es importante. Yo les mencionaba que el sujeto de mi oración activa vendría a ser el agente de mi oración pasiva, ¿ok? A bank was not stolen. Ok, recordamos que en la voz pasiva lo único que me importa es la acción, no me interesa quién realiza la acción. Por lo tanto, is correct if you don't put the agent. Ok, es correcto si aquí no ponemos al agente. En el caso de que quisiera poner al agente, a bank was not stolen by them. El banco no fue robado por ellos, ok. So here, you don't have to use that, ok. Ya no vamos a utilizar este sujeto they, ok. We are going to use the object pronouns, ok. Aquí ya vendríamos a utilizar the object pronouns, no the subject pronouns, ok. Lo tendríamos que hacer un pequeño cambio. So, thank you students, that is all for today. If you have any doubt, please tell me in order to solve your doubts or problems, okay? So, thank you, have a nice day, goodbye.